Traders, I'm going to finish my day up just over $11,000. I've got, I'm still riding BA and Win, so hopefully I'll get a bit more. I already have a bit more, but this is going to be a nice profitable day. I want to take a look at my main four trades today. I will disregard my last two losers, mRNA and FCEL, which were not the exact pattern I'm always looking for, but nevertheless, losers. So just take a look at the first four trade ideas today. That's BBY, BA, WIN, and BLNK. And just take a second and let me know what is really in common for all of these trades. I mean, what do you see? There's just one thing in common for these trades. One thing, one main trading system, really. Just one trick. What's that? What's in common with all of these four? Yeah, true. Yeah, absolutely. They're all gap and go. That's it. You know, traders, when we're trading stocks, lots of traders have different systems, but gaps are probably the main bread and butter system for almost every trader I know. In fact, I don't know a trader who doesn't trade gap and goes. Really, I don't know. So most traders do trade gaps, and among them, a lot of traders who trade gap and goes. And gap and goes are really quite amazing because you know how to expect them. You know what to expect. It is not as simple as it sounds. Like, okay, so it gaps and go, let's go short, let's go long. It's not as simple as it sounds. You do need a lot of experience. You do need a lot of knowledge. You know, it's just, I don't want it to sound too easy. It's absolutely not easy. But it is in common for many traders around the world to trade gap and goes because they are probably more expected than other. They are very volatile. That also means a lot of risk, but mainly they are our bread and butter trades. So just take a look at these four trades. The common thing among them is that they are all gap and goes. I was prepared pre-market time. That's also what's kind of nice. You can look for them pre-market time. You know that BBBY is going to start down 6 or 7%. You know BBY is a very big company, high volume. You know it's going to play a game today. And you know you have a chance of making money in BBY. I actually, my first trade in BBY was a losing trade. You know, the first time I took it, first 1, 2, 3 minutes here, it spiked over the highs. And then when it came down again, I took it once more because it was likely to come down. I was surprised to see it moving over the highs. I had no alternative but to move out of this trade once it moved over the highs. And that's why my second trade put me in green territory, but not much, because it was an amazing trade. It was a big loser too, but then it became a little bit bigger winner than a loser. Anyway, you see the same pattern in BBBY, which started with a gap down, tried to move higher, failed, and then came down. That was my second trade. In fact, first one was a loser. Look at Boeing, a gap up, came down. We found a reversal to take it for the long side, and it moved higher. BLNK was amazing, but look, it's a bit different. This one started with a gap down, crashed down initially, did not give us a chance to move in. We moved in at the second move down, which is much more dangerous than the first one. The first one would not be so dangerous. The second one would be more dangerous. The same applies for Boeing. Boeing failed to move higher here, came down more. That was a dangerous trade, a more dangerous trade. BBY's second trade was less dangerous. But BLNK came down, spiked down beautifully. WIN, again, started with a gap up, moved up, failed, came down, moved up, less dangerous because it's the first real move up. So we took WIN for the long side, and I'm still riding it. Boeing and WIN. So, you know, again, that's just the basics of gap and go. Stock is gapping up, you go long. Stock is gapping down, you go short. You just look for the reversal opportunity. Sometimes you're right, sometimes you're wrong. My first trade in BBY was wrong. Then, well, again, it came down. It finally did what was expected. Do they always do that? No, absolutely not. but they do it more than they don't. So if they do it like 70% of the time, in fact, they do it more. They do it probably 80% of the time or more. Like a stock that is gapping up would gap and go higher. A stock that's gapping down would gap down and go lower. But the thing is, you cannot have an 80% chance to succeed because sometimes they just take you out. They spike up or down, they'll take you out. It's not only about knowing that they will do it eventually, it's also knowing where to move in and also knowing when to move out and timing, of course. You know, timing is all, it's all about timing. If you don't have the right timing, then you're done. So even though you think it's going to gap and go up or gap and go down, you could still have a loser. I mentioned that earlier. It's not as simple as it sounds. You need a lot of experience. But the thing is, this is the bread and butter of a lot of traders. So if you guys don't, till now, traded gap and goes, if you're not familiar with the term gap and go, then I wanted to say, read a book or join us, learn about it. We talk about it in our Star Trader course. We talk about it quite a lot. I mean, it's one of the main strategies that we're learning. And of course, you need to get a lot of experience too. So a regular day, a green day. It's a nice second green day for me for the week. I want to thank you all for joining. And thank you guys in YouTube for joining us too. And again, I asked you earlier to give us a thumb up. If you're willing to give a thumb up, that will help our channel put in a lot of, draw in a lot of other people who are interested in trading to this trading room. We will appreciate that. So give us a second and click that button there. Thank you all for joining. I'll see you all tomorrow. It was a beautiful day. I really enjoyed it. And let's meet tomorrow again. Bye, traders.